policy that the school board sets forth. It's 68 degrees for heating season and 75 for the cooling season. Now, unless the space is occupied, like say for a basketball game, then it's run longer.
I think the school is really selfish with the heating system. All they want is a plaque on the wall saying that we are energy-saving school, but that doesn't really matter to anyone besides maybe the principal, and I think they should turn up the heat because it's really cold.
Do you know? And do you know? Do you know? Do you know what it feels like?
The heating and cooling system at Bayport is kind of inconsistent. It's hot during the summer and cold during the winter. Some rooms during the winter are steaming hot and some are freezing cold, so you kind of have to dress in layers in order to deal with it. Unfortunately, during the summer, you can only take off so many layers without embarrassing yourself. So I think really summer needs to be addressed, and I guess just dressing in layers is the best deal for the winter.
I feel like the school is way too cold and that it needs to be hotter, because if it's this cold, it's distracting to the learning environment and we can't concentrate because we're freezing our asses off.
So cold. Jesus Christ.
So why are you in the red pod stairs?
Because it's so warm and toasty.
Aww.
Winter, it's actually colder inside the building than outside when it's snowing.
Why are you outside, Alicia?
Why am I outside? It's so much warmer out here than it is in
snow. Hello, so you have a heating cooling question in regards to my take on it. I guess my first thing that comes to mind is the students constantly making comments about how cold my room is. I typically think it's my personality, but it's nice to know now that it's pretty much the temperature. I think on most days we are over 60 degrees. I'm going to get a thermometer to check for sure. I, however, use the sweater technique. I utilize a different sweater every day during the winter. No short sleeves, but I'm pretty tough. I'm not sure if everyone is. So I like cool, breezy, outdoor temperatures, and it makes me feel kind of at home in my classroom.
Okay, Bayport High School heating system really just is not cool. I mean, half the time during the winter, like, you walk into the cafeteria, and I'm sitting here, like, trying to eat my food, and my tater's already cold because the cafeteria is so darn cold. But then you got some rooms that you walk into, and it's blazing hot. You got to take off your sweatshirt. And then you get to the next room, and it's ice cold, and then you can barely fall asleep in class because I do that a lot. But, yeah, I think you guys need to start heating up the school, like, way.
It's cold in here, so I wear sweatshirts.
You have issues with the heating system at Bayport. I'm not one of those people because my room is hot because I'm hot-blooded. Check it and see. My room is always 103. The heating system around here is fine. We keep our house at 60 degrees. The wife is always hot. So I'm always, like, used to this temperature. I think it's amazing. Bayport rules.
This is Mr. Kluwer, representative of the art room. I have been asked about the heating situation or the temperature in the school, and I'm, you know, known as kind of an extreme, you know, living on the edge type. So I would say, you know, let's keep pushing this to the limits. I mean, I don't see any reason why we don't start every day lowering it 1 degree until, you know, we start having the first students with signs of hypothermia, and then we reconsider.
Poor,
you know
what?
Just keep drawing, it'll go away. Thank you.